This is true. We complement one another. Sorry if there's echo, y'all, but we complement one another when we all do our roles and what we're good at and what the Most High gifted us with as men and women. So I agree with that. I do. I agree. And I think if we all just listen more to one another, and I think also, because I was thinking as you were speaking, well, what about the hurt? It's probably the hurt that women sometimes when we endure so much. It's like it hurts so much. And but that then came to mind, forgiveness. And that's why I pray that all the couples here can start off with a clean slate. We'll try to work through it because it's not gonna work without forgiveness. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, I totally get the women get hurt from you know, stuff that happens and or from the man being sometimes like coming off possibly harsh in certain things because of the masculine energy, right, that you guys have. But also the men would have to forgive like when the woman made him feel less than a man as well. And I know it's hard too. I know you said you can forgive, but then also, but no, it's also still, but I can't, it's not the same. But you have to forgive. You have to try to start off a clean slate, y'all. It's both parties. I'm speaking to both women and men here to start off a clean slate. I get the hurt, I get the pain and stuff, but if it's gonna work, you have
Okay,
to.
let me help you out with that because that's generally not going to happen, and I could think I could speak for men from this perspective, so I don't think you know the equivalency because you're not a man, right? So
True, true.
when a woman makes a man feels less than a man, she's not coming back from that. Even if he forgives
Yeah.
her, she's not coming back from that.
Well, I get
So
it. I
a
get it.
woman makes a man feeling less than a man is equivalent to a woman going out and get raped by a man. Because that's how she's making him feel. And
Okay,
women
that makes
don't get that.
sense. That makes sense. That makes sense. That
They
makes
don't get
sense.
that. Because you there's nothing you took. It's like you deprived the man of his manhood. What else
Manhood.
is left? There's nothing left. There's nothing left. Once you make a man feel less than a man, you've literally deprived him of his manhood. And no matter
Right.
he could pretend, I mean, you know, he could forgive, but that's still kind of like the woman. Let me ask you this. If some guy raped you, right? And I mean physically, like rape you, right? Not be you told him no, and he just, I mean, just physically just trying to take, would you still want to be with him?
No, you're
That's
right.
the equivalency of a woman making a man feels less than a man. That's how it hits with men. And women don't get that. They think it's something he's just gonna blow off. That don't go away, man. That stay in your mind, because now in his mind, because a man has more of an ego than a woman, right? But when you crush a man's ego, that's it. Because in his mind, he's gonna keep replaying that, yeah, but she disrespected me. Like you know, I can't be with her anymore like that. You know what I mean? She and then she might be all right later. It's kind of like the rape victim, right? She'll keep getting memories. Now, if she's trying to go back and lay down with him, that is gonna keep resurfacing. You see what I'm saying? So it just takes away, and I, you know, I've been with people that experienced that, right? And the relationship didn't work out because they never healed from that. So they took that, like, you know, onto the next relationship because they hadn't healed, because they never forgave that person, right? You got to forgive them and move on. But I seriously doubt if you will be able to remain in a relationship because you was a victim to them. And so for a lot of men, that's how it feels when a woman makes him feel. I'm telling you, there's
That's
nothing.
true.
And women need to hear it. Oh yeah, whatever. You say, no, you really need to hear it because there's nothing equal that you could do other than committing adultery on him, because you made him feel less than a man. And that's all men really have, man. Especially a melanated man, right? They already took everything away from him. They took his woman. You see Nicholas Carefoot with his woman. So the only thing he got, the one last thing that he had that they couldn't take away from him is his woman. And now she left him for feminism. Right? So the only thing he has now is his manhood. And so when you do that, you pretty much emasculated the man. It's done. So yeah, he'll forgive, but even if he forgive her and if he remains in that, I just think it's like gonna be ongoing issues. Right? Because she just she should have stayed in her lane. certain things you don't do, man. It's kind of like the woman that the man has, you know, you dealt with this, Moshe, because you said you had a broken nose. Well, even if you want to be, you might have still loved this guy that did this to you for a while, right? Because there's something known as Stockholm Syndrome. Well, you start making excuses for the person that's like hurt you. Well, you start feeling sorry and trying to justify what they did. But when reality kicks in, you'd be like, yo, wait a minute. You know, you still had this phobia because you know there's a capacity that they might try and do it again. Well, so the man's going to have that same phobia, like, yo, she, especially if she do it publicly in front of people.
Yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah.
Man, that's like the ultimate thing right there. Are you going to someone else and you bad mouthing, you know, your man? Then you come back around and act like, yeah, everything's sweet. Everything's not sweet, man. Everything's not sweet. You can't do that to a man. And the only kind of women, and I know wise women know this. I know it because I seen women. There was this one chick I was dealing with from Jersey, and she had a grandma, and her grandma, they used to call her Ma Maggie, but she was one of the wisest melanated women I ever seen. Like, she passed into the spiritual realm now, but she will always tell him, like, yo, you better stop getting an attitude with him because, you know, there's always someone out here willing to do what you don't want to do. You see what I'm saying? She would tell her that. It's like, you know, you can't make him feel less than a man because when you do, he's, you know, no matter what, no matter how cute you are, you're just not going to be able to keep him. And she was taking that for granted until one day it just came to pass. Like, yeah, I'm done with her. Whatever. It's like certain things you just can't come back from, man. And so the only thing I know that I can like equate that to is, you know, some man just utterly taking advantage of a woman because that's how she's making a man feel. Mm-hmm. Like you just raped his whole manhood, man. Mm. And then saying I'm sorry, it don't fix it. Just like that girl or that woman that got taken advantage is not going to fix that, man. Even if he forgives, he got to forgive because if you don't forgive her, he's not going to heal. What? Yeah. But if you forgive, it's still there. You see what I'm saying? Because being a man is like a tough thing. It's kind of like in the street. If that happens with another guy, you know, you're going to shoot joints. It's just the bottom line. You're going to shoot joints. You say certain things. Oh, that was it. Bam. Yeah, I mean, he just snuck him. Because you don't say that. You see what I'm saying? You certain things you don't say is on. But it's the same thing. She could do that with her mouth. And no creature on this earth could out-argue a black woman. So no one can make a man feel as bad as his woman. Understand that. Because a woman is around a man. She studies him. Mm-hmm. And she knows how to push his buttons. You see what I'm saying?
That's true.
The same person that can make you feel so loved, that person can make you feel the worst and the worst that anyone else can. Because they know you and they know how to push your buttons. And that's why it's hard to come back from that.
Facts. 100%.
We can see from the man's perspective. And I think it's good for us to all ponder on this. You know, I have a younger brother and, he's a man. And, he went through some stuff that he got through. And I know that it did take a lot of him. And it's hard to be a man because he don't just come to us and talk to us about it. You know what I mean?
Right.
He's not going to do that. You know what I'm saying? And right. So that's so true. You know, looking at it. Hindsight, and a lot of you women are raising up boys to be men. Wait, boys to men. boys to be men. And so
the women are ripping them off like Michael Bivins.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They robbing boys to men like Michael Bivins.
That was a punchline. Bars. No, but thinking on it, you know, y'all have sons and No, I wouldn't want nobody to do that to my son or my nephew. You know, and there's a lot of wicked women, but there's a lot of wicked men out there too, but there's a lot of also women that are very selfish nowadays. And I see it, like, I'm talking about the type to be out just doing the most and just not doing their responsibilities at all. Just leave, you know, y'all know, I don't want to get too deep into that, but you know, so, your sons may come across that. So this is good to know. And I think that's why the Most High also did marriage unions, to also show women and men how to love each other and how to see the differences the differences within each other as strengths together, like a puzzle piece or something, you know. So I just think that it could work with understanding and love, but I do totally get how it can make a man feel like he stripped his manhood away. So that makes sense. So I learned a lot again tonight. This is a very edifying channel, you know. At first was a little taboo for me because y'all know I'm always with the elders on the prayer line and they don't be cursing and stuff. But I said, well, he's a relational creator. So no one can learn that way. He's like, you're becoming cultish now. If you just go on there, you just like, it's becoming now routine. Y'all on there every day. You need also to, I'm sending you forth amongst my other sheep. I have some sheep of this fold you know nothing of. So he's showing me more, and that's how we're going to grow. So this was a very edifying topic. You know, the Most High is showing me you cannot judge with the eyes of, you know, looking through the eyes of a human. So I'm learning more, and as I'm learning, I'm just praying also for all the people to heal that went through hurt in these situations as well, and for everything to get better. You know, for all parties involved, and for, again, the children, because the children are what is the main important thing here. You know, so blessings.
But here's the problem, man. Like, so sometimes, and I know there's guys that have experience with this, right? Sometimes you forgive Eve, and she do it again, and that's how you know you made a mistake. So see, I know what you're saying about the whole forgive your brother 70 times 7, but it doesn't say you still have to be around him, huh?
True.
You could forgive someone, but you know, that doesn't mean you have to still stay within their vicinity if they keep crossing you. You see what
That's
I'm saying?
True.
Because
true.
You said it yourself earlier, the definition of insanity. So that goes with forgiving also.
That's true.
Say, forgive your brother 70 times 7. All right, I forgive you, man. But you stay over there. Because that chapter in my book is done. Now I'm moving to a different chapter right now. Because you crossed me too many times. You see what I'm saying? That doesn't mean you're not forgiven. You're taking that toxicity.